The objective of this video is to provide you with the general recommendations on how to use the Atlan family devices for long-term ventilation. Clinical staff should be instructed in the use of the anesthesia device and also should be familiarized with its functionalities. Make sure an experienced anesthesia colleague is always available, like for example an anesthesiologist, available for you 24/7. In the case of any problem, please call for help in an earlier stage. Before connecting the patient to the system, you have to verify the readiness of the system and the accessories. More details will be shared with you later on this video. An emergency resuscitator must always be available for you in the workplace. This is to make sure the patient can be ventilated in the case of any failure on the device. Make sure nitrous oxide is not supplied to the anesthesia device. You have to disconnect the hose, starting with the source and finally in the back of the anesthesia device. Make use of the manual spontaneous mode only after being instructed by an experienced anesthesia colleague. When using the anesthesia device for long-term ventilation, it is not recommendable to use the external fresh gas outlet, neither the pause mode. Be aware that the anesthesia device, when using volume control ventilation modes, will not automatically compensate the leakages. Therefore, pressure control ventilation are preferred. To do so, just go to the pressure control ventilation tab and confirm using the rotary knob. In a situation of fresh gas flow deficit, you can spot a leakage by looking at the manual breathing bag. It will be emptied. When so, you have to act immediately. You have to detect and eliminate the leakages. You have to increase the fresh gas flow. Additionally, you can deattach the manual breathing bag. This will allow ambient air to be drawn into the system. But keep in mind that the fraction of inspired oxygen will be between the set level of oxygen and 21% from the ambient air. Always stay in the vicinity of the anesthesia device. Please remember the design of the alarm management was meant for the operating theater. When using the anesthesia device for long-term ventilation, always raise the level of the alarm to the maximum. To do so, please press on the alarm button, then go to the settings tab and increase the alarm volume to the maximum. You confirm the selection by pressing the rotary knob. Keep in mind that the anesthesia device will automatically delete the message of the alarms when the situation triggering the alarm is not present anymore. To verify on the alarm that might have occurred in the absence of the user, just go to the alarm button and then go to the logbook tab. In there, you will see all the alarms. When using the anesthesia device for long-term ventilation, you have to check on the accessories frequently, at least every 12 hours. Soda lime canister, gas measurement water trap, breathing hose system, and patient filter. To verify on the condition of the soda lime, you have to visually inspect it. Make sure that no more of 2/3 of its content has changed in color. Additionally, you have to monitor the inspired CO2. Make sure that its value is not higher than 5 millimeters of mercury. You have to frequently check the gas measurement water trap. If there is more than 50% of its capacity filled with water, you will have to drain it. The procedure to drain the water trap is first detaching the sample line. Then you extract the water trap. You will see in the lower part the color port. You have to drain it from here using a standard syringe. You put it in place and drain. You might have to repeat the process if there is still water remaining on the trap. Once you have drained it, you put the empty water trap back on the port and reattach the sample line. You have to frequently verify the condensed water on the breathing hose system. The recommendation is to use a breathing hose system with water trap. You have to turn and open the water trap, and you drain its content. Then you put it back in place. Remember that when using the anesthesia device, always should use a mechanical filter. When using it for long-term ventilation, the recommendation is to use a mechanical filter with HME. That is to improve the passive humidification of the system. When the filter is soaked or too humid, you have to exchange it. And remember to place it in the system the closest possible to the patient. The hospital guidelines with regards to infection prevention and control should always be followed. Always make sure that the gas measure in serpon line is tightly connected to the water trap and to the patient filter. Remember, it is through this that we are performing the gas measurement on the system. Keep close monitoring of the CO2 and oxygen measurement. Be aware that the inspired fraction of oxygen might deviate from the set portion of oxygen in the fresh gas flow due to the rebreathing system. Be aware that the manual breathing bag should be fully and evenly filled, and it will also move in synchronization with the mechanical ventilation. Drug nebulization and aerosol therapy are not suitable for the anesthesia device. An important recommendation: remove from the anesthesia device all vaporizers. The minimum quantity of anesthetic agent might trigger malignant hyperthermia on the patient or in the clinical staff. To do so, press the button and turn the dial to the T for transport position. Then turn the lever and take the vaporizer out. Be aware that the vaporizer is heavy. The anesthesia device should be checked through the self test in normal condition every 24 hours. When used for long-term ventilation, it must be checked at least every 72 hours. Clinical staff should be instructed in the use of the anesthesia device and also should be familiarized with its functionalities.